So hi guys, and welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. We will discuss guys some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD in this session. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And you can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Alright, so let's begin with the very first question, which is about the National Panchayati Raj Day. So on the National Panchayati Raj Day that was observed on 24th of April, the Ministry of Panchayati Raj, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, has awarded the best performing panchayats or states or UTs across the country in recognition of their good work. Question is, what was new in this year's awarding event? Is saal ka jo awarding event tha usme kya khas baat thi, kya nayi baat thi, kya aisi cheez thi jo pehli baar ki gayi in this year's awarding event of the National Panchayati Raj Day? So let's discuss about this. So there were various events that were organized during the National Panchayati Raj Day this year. Like for example, we have discussed that the government has distributed the e-cards, e-property cards under the Swamitva scheme on this day. And these are the awards guys that were presented on this day. Number one is Deen Dayal Upadhyay Panchayat Sashaktikaran Puraskar, Nanaji Deshmukh Rashtriya Gaurav Gram Sabha Puraskar. Then we have Child Friendly Gram Panchayat Award, Gram Panchayat Development Plan Award, and E-Panchayat Puraskar, which is meant only for the states or UTs, not for the districts or the local panchayats. Alright. And it was for the first time. Pehli baar aisa hua that Prime Minister has transferred the award money as grants in aid directly to the bank accounts of the panchayat concerned. Jo bhi panchayat thi, directly uske bank account mein uska paisa, jo award winning price tha, jo award winning amount tha, uske panchayat ke account mein directly transfer kiya gaya. Alright. So this was for the first time it was done during this awarding event of the National Panchayati Raj Day. Alright. So I hope you can easily answer this question now. So what was new in this year's awarding event? So the award money was transferred directly to the bank account of the panchayat. Alright. So this should be the correct answer, but let's read out other options also. A new category of announced was of award was announced named as Women Friendly Gram Panchayat Award. No. ऐसा कोई अवार्ड अनाउंस नहीं हुआ है, देयर इज नो सच अवार्ड दैट वाज अनाउंस्ड. ई पंचायत पुरस्कार व्हिच वर गिवन टू स्टेट्स और यूटीज ओनली नाउ स्टार्टेड फॉर डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स आल्सो. नो, इट इज करेंटली फॉर स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज ओनली, इट इज नॉट मेंट फॉर द डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स. सो दैट मींस गाइस ऑप्शन ए विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर बिकॉज वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट वाज न्यू थिंग इन दिस ईयर्स अवार्डिंग इवेंट, ऑप्शन ए. एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. यूएस प्रेसिडेंट जो बाइडेन hosted a virtual meeting of world leaders titled Leaders Summit on Climate on the occasion of Earth Day, that was, we all know, on the 22nd of April. Which of the following is incorrect about the actions taken by India for mitigating climate change, that was remarked by Prime Minister of India at this summit? India ke dwara liye gaye jo actions hain for mitigating the climate change, uske regarding hame incorrect statement batani hai jo ki hamare Prime Minister ne aur ye jo इंडिया के स्टेप्स हैं ये हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने बताए हैं एट दी समिट. सो लेट्स डिस्कस दिस न्यूज. सो यूएस प्रेसिडेंट जो बाइडेन होस्टेड दिस वर्चुअल समिट विच इज टाइटल्ड एज लीडर्स समिट ऑन क्लाइमेट ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ वर्ल्ड अर्थ डे, दैट इज ऑन 22nd April, एंड 40 लीडर्स फ्रॉम द इंटरनेशनल कम्युनिटी वर इन्वाइटेड फॉर दिस समिट इंक्लूडिंग इंडियाज प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी. एंड व्हाट वॉज द पर्पज, इसका पर्पज क्या था? So its purpose was to galvanize efforts by the major economies, by the major countries to tackle the climate change and underscore the urgency and economic benefits of stronger climate action. Stronger climate action ke kya kya economic benefits ho sakte hain uske bare mein discuss karna was one of the objective of this summit that was organized by US President Joe Biden. Now what were the elaborated objectives, iske agar hum overall objectives ki baat kare to kya kya objectives the iske? To get the world's major economies to reduce emission in this decade while also getting the public and private sector involvement in mitigation of the climate change. To show how climate action can have economic and social benefits. Jo hamara climate action hai, agar hum climate mitigation, agar hum climate change ko mitigate kar sakte hain, to uske kya economic aur social benefits honge, isko show karne ke liye. Using the technology available to adapt to climate change but also reduce emissions. जो हमारे पास टेक्नोलॉजी है उसको यूज करके हम किस तरीके से क्लाइमेट चेंज को खत्म कर सकते हैं, जो हमारा क्लाइमेट चेंज हो रहा है उसको रोक सकते हैं. फॉर दिस दिस समिट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज एंड टू प्रोटेक्ट लाइव एंड लाइवलीहुड बाई फाइंडिंग वेज टू अडेप्ट टू द क्लाइमेट चेंज. जो हमारे लाइव्स और लाइवलीहुड्स हैं उनको किस तरीके से प्रोटेक्ट किया जा सकता है बाय फाइंडिंग वेज टू अडैप्ट टू द क्लाइमेट चेंज वाज आल्सो वन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द समिट. नाउ देयर वाज सम अनाउंसमेंट दैट वाज मेड बाय द यूनाइटेड स्टेट. इट वाज अनाउंस्ड दैट द यूएस वुड कट इट्स ग्रीन हाउस गैस एमिशन बाय 50-50% बाय द ईयर 2030 रिलेटिव टू 2005 लेवल्स. 2005 के लेवल के हिसाब से जो यूएसए है वो 50-50% लेवल ऑफ गैस ग्रीन हाउस गैस एमिशन को कट डाउन करेगा by the year 2030. And it was also announced that the US would double its annual financial commitments to the developing world. जो developing countries को annual financial commitment जाता है for mitigating the climate change, it will be doubled by the year 2024, including a tripling of its adaptation finance by 2024. और climate change को adapt करने के लिए जो finance दिया जाता है, that will be tripled by the year 2024. Okay? And these are India's strategy towards climate change mitigation as pointed out by our PM during the summit. Number one is to fix the renewable energy target of 450 gigawatts by the year 2030. Guys, we all know we have a target of this much production of renewable energy by 2030 and 175 gigawatt by the year 2022. I hope aap sabko ye pata hai. India's nationally determined contributions are 2 degrees Celsius. India and US are launching the India-US Climate and Clean Energy Agenda 2030 partnership. India's per capita carbon footprint is 60% lower than the global average. And sustainable lifestyles and the guiding philosophy of back to basics must be an important pillar of our economic strategy for the post-COVID era. So these are some of the strategies that were announced by the prime ministers during the summit. All right. And now guys, let's come back to the question. So you have to identify the incorrect statement regarding the actions taken by India for mitigating the climate change. Number one is fixing renewable energy targets of 450 gigawatts by 2030. This is absolutely correct. India's nationally determined contributions are 2 degrees Celsius compatible. Yes, this is absolutely correct. India's per capita carbon footprint is 60% lower than the global average. This is also correct. India and US are launching the India-US Climate and Clean Energy Agenda 2030 partnership. This is also correct, which means, guys, all the statements are absolutely correct. Option E would be the correct answer. Alright. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. Ministry of Dash announces hashtag FOSS for GOV Innovation Challenge. You have to fill this gap. Which ministry has announced this hashtag FOSS for GOV Innovation Challenge? So let's discuss this. This is Ministry of Electronics and IT which has announced this challenge, which is known as hashtag FOSS for GOV Challenge. Now, what is FOSS? FOSS stands for Free and Open Source Software. Free and Open Source Software. And this challenge has been announced to increase awareness about the usage of free and open source software in the governance and government functioning and its adoption. जो फॉस है फ्री एंड ओपन सोर्स सॉफ्टवेयर की अडॉप्शन के लिए उसके अवेयरनेस को इंक्रीज करने के लिए दिस चैलेंज हैज बीन अनाउंस्ड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड आईटी व्हिच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर रवि शंकर प्रसाद. हिज लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी वी ऑल नो गाइस इज पटना साहिब. ऑलराइट, पटना साहिब से है ये. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट फ्री एंड ओपन सोर्स सॉफ्टवेयर, ये होता क्या है? सो बेसिकली गाइज, इट इज अ सॉफ्टवेयर दैट कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज बोथ फ्री एंड ओपन सोर्स. एंड रिमेंबर, this is the software that is freely licensed to use, copy, study and change the software in any way, and the source code is openly shared so that people are encouraged to voluntarily improve the design of the software. Like for example, agar aapne dekha hoga linux is the best example for this. So the guys, there are various softwares. Agar aap software download karne jate hain, if you go for downloading the software, then it asks for the licenses. But for the free and open source software, there are no licenses. Anyone can use, anyone can copy, anyone can study, and anyone can change the software in the way they like. All right. So this is about the free and open source software. Now, what is the India's position at free and open source software? So India is well positioned to become a vibrant hub for FOSS innovations due to the large number of 4G data subscribers in our country. Some of the India's largest government projects like Aadhaar and many technology startups have also been built using FOSS, free and open source software. And acknowledging the huge potential of FOSS, the government has also announced the policy on adoption of open source software in the year 2015. 2015 mein hi Bharat Sarkar ne iske regarding ek policy announce kar di thi. All right. एंड नाउ लास्टली टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस चैलेंज, इस चैलेंज में क्या क्या होगा? सो इट विल कॉल अपॉन दी फॉस इनोवेटर्स, टेक्नोलॉजी एंटरप्रेनर्स एंड इंडियन स्टार्टअप्स टू सबमिट इम्प्लीमेंटेबल ओपन सोर्स प्रोडक्ट इनोवेशन. ऐसे ओपन सोर्स प्रोडक्ट इनोवेशन को सबमिट करना है जो कि इम्प्लीमेंटेबल हो मार्केट में, विथ पॉसिबल एप्लीकेशन फॉर गवर्नमेंट टेक इन हेल्थ एजुकेशन एग्रीकल्चर अर्बन गवर्नेंस एटसेट्रा. एंड पार्टिसिपेंट्स गाइज विल ऑल्सो भी एलिजिबल फॉर इंक्यूबेशन सपोर्ट, प्राइज मनी, मेंटोरशिप बाय डोमेन एक्सपर्ट्स एटसेट्रा. दे विल गेट इंक्यूबेशन सपोर्ट, दे विल गेट प्राइज मनी, दे विल गेट मेंटोरशिप, दे विल गेट इंस्टीट्यूशनल सपोर्ट फ्रॉम दी वेरियस ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस from the government of India side. All right. So this was about this news, guys. And now let's come back to the question. So the correct answer should be what? Option E. Ministry of Electronics and IT. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is the last question for today. And guys, remember, फिर से COVID का माहौल फैल चुका है. So there are very less news. All the news are related to COVID-19. So we can't do anything. हो सकता है कभी 4 question हो सकता है कभी 5 question हो. So please don't worry, in future news आएगी, then I'll cover all the news, alright. और अभी कोई news है नहीं, अच्छी बात भी आप लोगों के लिए कि आपको कम cover up करना पड़ेगा for the exam, alright. So consider the following statements regarding the World Press Freedom Index and you have to identify the incorrect statement out of these 5. Out of these 5, you have to identify incorrect statement regarding the World Press Freedom Index. Now who releases, which organization releases this? It's Reporters Without Borders, which is headquartered in Paris. It is headquartered in Paris, and in Paris you will also find the headquarter of UNESCO, and you will also find the headquarter of International Energy Agency, OECD, etc. So now let's come to the news. So India has ranked 142nd out of 180 nations in the recently released World Press Freedom Index, and this is very poor ranking of a country which is democratic in nature. Norway has topped once again for 5th year in a row. Norway पिछले 5 साल से number 1 पे है, followed by Finland and Denmark. Eritrea is at the bottom, China is ranked at 177 while Pakistan is at 145. तो हमारे neighbors भी कुछ कम नहीं है, वो भी सारे कलाकार है. Now talking about the index, so as I told you, it is published every year since 2002 by Reporters Without Borders, which is based in Paris. It is an independent NGO with consultative status with the United Nations, UNESCO, the Council of Europe and the International Organization of Francophonie. Alright, so this is basically an independent NGO jisko kai international organizations ka support mila hua hai. And this index ranks countries and regions according to the level of freedom available to the journalist. However, it is not an indicator. Ye jo basically ye countries or regions ko रैंक करता है अकॉर्डिंग टू द लेवल ऑफ फ्रीडम जो कि जर्नलिस्ट को मिला है, बट ये एक पैरामीटर नहीं है. पैरामीटर्स इसके अलग अलग होते हैं. लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल, द पैरामीटर्स इंक्लूड प्लूरलिज्म, मीडिया इंडिपेंडेंस, मीडिया एनवायरनमेंट एंड सेल्फ सेंसरशिप, लेजिस्लेटिव फ्रेमवर्क, ट्रांसपेरेंसी एंड द क्वालिटी ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर दैट सपोर्ट द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ न्यूज एंड इन्फॉर्मेशन. एंड गाइज, हम सभी को पता है कि इंडिया में क्या हालत है जर्नलिज्म की, हम सबको पता है. तो इसलिए 142nd रैंक आना इज नॉट अ बिग सरप्राइज फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. इन इंडियाज परफॉर्मेंस एनालिसिस की बात करें, सो इन 2016 इंडियाज रैंक वाज 133, बट नाउ इट हैज डिक्रीज टू 142 इन द ईयर 2020. दिस रिपोर्ट सेज दैट इंडिया इज वन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स मोस्ट डेंजरस कंट्रीज फॉर जर्नलिज्म. सो दैट इज गाइज अगेन अ वेरी हार्ट ब्रेकिंग थिंग फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस, बिकॉज वी आर क्लेम दैट वी आर अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री, एंड इन अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री अगर जर्नलिज्म की हालत ये होगी, देन हाउ वी कैन से दैट वी आर अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री. 142nd एंड द रिपोर्ट इज सेइंग दैट वी आर द वर्ल्ड्स मोस्ट डेंजरस कंट्रीज, वन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स मोस्ट डेंजरस कंट्रीज फॉर जर्नलिज्म. सो दिस इज नॉट गुड फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. इट स्टेट्स दैट अ जर्नलिस्ट इन द कंट्री आर एक्सपोज टू एवरी काइंड ऑफ अटैक. 2020 में इंडियन एक्सप्रेस का एक आर्टिकल आया था जिसमें बताया था कि 2020 में मोर देन 50 जर्नलिस्ट पे हमले हुए हैं. इवन पुलिस वायलेंस अगेंस्ट द रिपोर्टर्स, ambushes by political activities and reprisals instigated by criminal groups or the corrupt local officials. So basically journalism ki halat bahut zyada kharab hai. They have a very pitiful situation in our country. So that's it about this World Press Freedom Index. Now we have to identify the incorrect statement. India has been ranked 142nd out of 180 nations. This is absolutely correct. Norway has topped again for the 5th year in the row. Eritrea is at the bottom. Correct. The first edition of the report was released in 2005. That was not 2005, guys. That was 2002 when the first edition of this report was released. So this would be the correct answer, option D, because we have to identify the incorrect statement. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.